What up, people? My name is Colt. I'm a creator out here in New York City, and today I have the honor of showing you around Adobe's latest release, Photoshop on iPhone, right here on Adobe Photoshop's very own YouTube channel. You now have the power of Photoshop right in the palm of your hand, so without further ado, let's take a little tour as I show you how to become larger than life with Photoshop on iPhone. I'm gonna try to sit on top of this building over here. All right, so we'll start by opening up Photoshop on iPhone. And a cool thing is you can log into your Creative Cloud account and all your previous projects from other devices are synced to this app. So you can access current project files, but today we're gonna start a new one from fresh. And if you hit this blue plus button on the bottom, here you have your options to create a new project. But a cool thing that is unique to Photoshop on iPhone is you can create a project by taking a picture straight from your iPhone camera. So I'm gonna click take a photo. And using my iPhone camera, I'm gonna take this photo like this. And just like that, we have a new project open that is the exact dimensions of the photo we just took. So the goal of this project is to kind of make it look like I'm gigantic and sitting on the corner of this building over here. And the first step to doing so is preparing our backplate. So we just took a photo of this building and I'm liking the composition, but there are some things that I want to take out. So to start, I'm trying to get rid of this kind of distracting building overhang on the top right of the image. And to do so, we'll click select area. In this tab, we have our classic tools that you're familiar with, but a new tool that's unique to Photoshop on iPhone is called tap to select. Now with this tool, we can simply tap on objects within the frame and Photoshop on iPhone will kind of figure out what you're trying to select. But a cool thing is it automatically populates selections of what it thinks you may want. And actually the thing that we're trying to select is over here on the right. So if we tap that, we have our selection, we'll hit the check mark. And just like that, the distracting object that we're trying to get rid of is selected. Now that we have our selection, we have a selection window that pops up that has a couple of different things that we may want to do. And a big feature that I'm excited that Adobe has included on Photoshop on iPhone is Generative Fill. This tool has been very helpful on the desktop version of Photoshop, and to now have it on the mobile version of Photoshop on iPhone really feels like there's no compromise when going between devices. And we're gonna use this tool to remove the object. So we'll click Generative Fill, and I'll type in remove. And just like that, our distraction is no more. So now we have our backplate, and the next step we're gonna do is open up our layers panel. And with this, duplicate our current layer. So we have our backplate, and now we're gonna go on to the next step, which is masking out the building. So with your top layer selected, we're gonna click select area. Tap to select worked pretty well last time, so we're gonna go back to it. And as you can see, it already flagged the buildings as architecture, so we'll click that. Now when I'm sitting on the building, to really sell it that I'm up there, I have to make it look like I'm in front of the buildings in the background, but behind the buildings in the foreground. So we can actually modify our selection. I'm gonna click the quick to select brush and hit the minus. And I'm just gonna take away the back building that is selected over here and the back building selected over here. And now we have our foreground building isolated. So we'll click apply as mask. And now we have two layers, one that is the building in the foreground. And now we have a backplate that I can kind of just like sandwich myself in and kind of blend it all together. So the next step is we're gonna click the plus button and create an image layer. And now we can add photos directly from our phone's photo album. So I'll click add from photos. And to save time, I already took some photos, but the key to really selling this effect is you have to match the perspective that you took the original photo, your backplate, and also the lighting. So after importing our image, our next step is to separate myself from the background. So we'll go back to select area, and tap select's been working pretty well, so we're gonna do that once again. And I already see a selection that is kind of close to what I want, so we'll click on that. You also have the ability to refine your mask. So I like using the quick select brush, and there's some things that I want to add to the selection. So I can simply draw in what I want, and if I hit the subtract button, I can subtract the things that I don't want. And with our selection looking pretty good, we'll hit apply as mask once again. And just like that, we're getting pretty close to the final image. If we hit layer properties, you can transform your layer and kind of just like tweak everything to get the perspective that we're really going after. And we're almost done. So to really sell this effect, we're going to move our foreground mask to the front. And as you can see, it cuts off some of our image. But what we want is to kind of blend this image together to make it look like I'm really sitting on top of the building. So what we'll do is if we hit the paintbrush, we can actually use the eraser tool and change our values up a little bit and kind of paint in the parts of the building that we want to be shown and kind of blend in the elements like my leg and shoe. So to really blend this all together, I made another separate layer and then painted in some shadows. And after all is said and done, this is the final image that we ended up with, where I'm sitting on top of this beautiful building back here. This was how to make yourself larger than life using Photoshop on iPhone. Thank you for coming to the tutorial. I hope you learned a thing or two. And thank you to Adobe for having me on Adobe Photoshop's very own YouTube channel. Check the link in the description to download Photoshop on iPhone for free today. And with that, go live your life. You live your larger than life life. And that's all I had to say.